torque offset is ever more commonly talked about. But what is it? And what effect does it have on the overall feeling of our bikes? The onset of offset, what is it all about? So, what is offset? Well, most mountain bikers are probably very familiar with talking about the head tube angle of their bikes. So we have our steering axis coming down here. Offset is how far the front axle is offset or in front of that steering axis. And changing the amount of offset on a fork is a way to affect how much of our weight sits on the front wheel of our bikes. To talk about offset, I'm actually gonna talk about our stems, but hear me out. The reason I'm gonna talk about stems is it's something you've most likely experimented with. And I want you to call upon that experience you have whilst I'm talking about offset to help quantify what I'm referring to. So, stems. The longer your stem is, the more stable your front end is, because the more weight is being exercised upon the front wheel. Conversely, the shorter your stem is, the more rearward your weight is in relation to the front wheel. So with a short stem, something like 40 or 50 mil, steering can be more responsive, but it can go too far and come across all twitchy and unstable. That's because, you guessed it, there is not enough weight upon the front wheel. That means that there isn't our weight driving our wheel into the ground to deliver grip. There isn't that auto-correcting sensation you get with a nice long stem. Think of it like dipping your heels as you ride through rough terrain. You're not making yourself heavier, but you are weighting the bike in a certain way to make it feel more stable, to achieve grip and drive. This is what a long stem achieves. Hence, why professional road riders who achieve warp speed want that nice long stem paired to a relatively short top tube to give them that much needed stability. Another good way to think about offset is to think of what we know about chainstays. Now, the longer your chainstay is, the more it weights the front wheel and takes weight off the rear wheel. Now, this might sound slightly ridiculous, but if we take that knowledge and apply it to our forks, if we had an offset of 1,000, it would actually be taking pretty much all of the weight off the front and be putting it upon the rear wheel. So hopefully that's a good way to quantify where our weight sits in relation to the bottom bracket and our axles. So weight on the front wheel is good. Viva la long stems. Stability, boy oh boy, now we are talking. But is it that simple? Well, maybe not. We've moved away from long stems for aggressive riding for a couple of reasons. If we combine a short stem with a longer frame, we can get our weight to sit more centrally. Plus, stubbier stems tend to play a lot nicer with our nice slack head angles that have become ever more prevalent. That twitchy feeling that a short stem can cause is actually quite nice for striking a balance of stability with our super wide handlebars. So, the modern mountain bike, perfection, right? Well, maybe not. There is a term called trail, which is often overlooked, but less so recently. But what does it mean, and how does it relate to the rest of our bikes? Trail is the number derived by measuring the distance between your contact patch, so directly below your front axle, and the angle of your fork axis as it dissects the ground. The larger the trail number, the greater the self-centering stability will feel on the wheel. The lower the trail figure, then the more twitchy your steering will be. Why don't we try reducing that offset on the forks, a number we landed on many a year ago. This will help us weight the front wheel by increasing the trail number, giving lots of grip, whilst letting us reap the collective benefits of all the other changes in progressive geometry. It's going to mean we can generate a very stable bike that's nice and roomy in the cockpit, but also it enables us to weight the front wheel a bit more by reducing that front center slightly. So as you can imagine, as we slacken our head tube angle, it has a drastic effect on that trail number. Similarly, when we raise our front axles, it also has a really big effect. So in the last couple of years, more people are riding big wheeled bikes and have slacker head angles than their dizziest daydreams of a few years ago. So it's no surprise that we've landed on offset as a cause of conversation, because it's a very logical thing to think about changing. Can this go too far? Well, absolutely. trail is a number and there is a sweet spot. We know from our long stems that that stability-inducing feeling is absolutely fantastic at high speed, but it can cause the wheel to bite and be a cause of instability at low speed. The theory being that high amounts of trail give stability kind of goes out the window when we begin to lean the bike. Like everything, it's a compromise. Think of it like standing up. As we widen our stance, it can actually give us a huge amount of stability, but only in one direction, a la trail. But if we start leaning forward and back, it can actually be a cause and generate instability. This is the conundrum. Like everything on our bikes, it's a balancing act. Literally, in this case, namaste. Forks are available in many different offsets now, be it Fox, RockShox, Suntour, Formula, whatever. You just have to choose your flavour. Today, we're using this system from Mojo Rising, as opposed to anyone else's forks, just because the adjustment is all in the same fork, and it saves us trying three individual setups. We can just change the offset and ride back-to-back different settings in this comparison. Now a small caveat. Is offset important? Absolutely, but it is just one piece in the larger puzzle of our bikes. It's just as important as something like stem length, as if people still talk about that when it is so 2013. What I'm trying to say is there are no golden tickets in bike design, and everything we change has a ramification within the larger picture of our bikes. So what fiendish plan have we come up with to try out this system? Well, it's undoubtedly very cunning and highly sophisticated. For weeks, I have been scouring roots and rain with various algorithms and formulas to find out the perfect candidate, and I'm very confident I have done so. We've got our very own Top Gear Stig, an anonymous racer, to push this fork to its absolute limits to hopefully give some feedback about how the different settings feel. And of course, I'm not going to tell him what offset he's running. So who is our mystery rider? Well, they've won national downhill and enduro races. They've top 10'd at World Cups. And if you feed them a few stiff shandies, they'll tell you all about the time they won Rear of the Year in 2007. Who is this mystery rider? Well,
all right, Henry.
It's Neil, it's meant to be anonymous. Can we pixelate his face? I'm sorry, mate, I told you to wear full face and tints.
Oh, sorry, I missed that, man, sorry.
Can you just put this on so we can disguise your appearance?
What is that?
It's a highly sophisticated, that's straight from MI5, that. That's what they use in the field.
Should have had a shave.
It's all right. So it's Norris, first run. He hasn't ridden these forks at all yet. He's in the 46mm offset, but he doesn't know that. And away we go. It'll be really interesting to hear his thoughts. So we've changed the fork settings a bit to reduce his offset, but don't tell him. Let's see how this anonymous rider goes on for his second run. So we've had two tests. Now, I'm not going to tell you which one was which, but one of them was slightly longer than the stock setup on the Strive. One was slightly shorter. And now we have this, which is obviously very different.
Oh, it's much shorter. I mean, it looks crazy, doesn't it? From the side, from up here, bird's eye view, it looks all right.
I had a little wander around the car park. So what we've done, it's not immediately obvious, is swapped round the crowns. Now, this isn't advisable to do at home, but it's going to make an interesting experiment. So we've swapped around the crowns and put that flip chip in its most extreme position. So I think it gives an offset of almost like zero. It's really, really, if you drew a line through the head tube to the axle.
It doesn't feel as crazy as it looks, just riding along the flat. It feels like you are like putting a lot of input into the bike the whole time. It feels like you're turning a lot to sort of just keep your balance. So
it felt to me like when we just rode around there, if I closed my eyes, it felt like I was riding a road bike with a really short top tube and a really long stem.
Yeah, true.
Just that kind of, oh my God, like the way it arced. But anyway, so we're gonna go for a bit of a potter. Well, you are. I always potter. You're gonna see how we go. And one day we're at the pub, I guess.
All right, let's do it. Feel bad, but that's when for me, like wheelbase, like that feels like the biggest difference. But if you're going straight through rough stuff, wheelbase to me doesn't make that much difference. Whereas if you change the head angle by 2 degrees, I would really notice it. This doesn't feel like a huge difference. So anyway, when you add it all together, for me, I've always been really sensitive about front wheel weight and being able to drift a bike rather than just slide on the front. And that's been all, everything together, stackers under your stem, bar rise, head angle.
But do you feel that, you know, offset is obviously something we can change with a system like that, and that's great, but you can't view any one part of a bike in isolation. You know, fork set where it sits in the travel, that affects head angle, which then affects this.
Exactly,
which affects
how progressive your fork is actually dynamically affects where your weight is, not just, like when I was riding around on this, you can really feel the difference, I think. In when you're going slow and you're just turning along far road, it feels different. But when you're riding hard down this, you're only changing one thing and don't feel that huge amount of difference.
So there is our day wrapped up of trying out different offsets back to back.
Yeah, fun day.
Yeah, now I've kind of experimented with this actually just last week. I wanted to kind of get my head around it and really understand the nuanced world of this.
Well, I mean, something that I don't, because in the past, it's something that, you know, you couldn't really change your offset. You had what you were given and that was it. Yeah. So for me, I was more dialed in on head angles, bar height, all these sort of different things, whereas this offset is a new one to me. Yeah. And it's a difficult one to get your head around, right?
Yes. Could you tell, what do you feel you were trying, you know, if for the first one, second one, well, setups, could you tell the difference?
I mean, yeah, visually for me, you can see when I get on a bike, I look down, you can sort of get a gauge on a head angle and all these sorts of things like reach just by sitting on your bike. So it did feel like it was coming further towards me.
Yeah.
Obviously the last one, it was very obvious, it was right back.
Yeah, yeah.
And again, it's sort of only when I'm riding around a car park where I can really notice the difference. Yeah. Like you say, a bit more agile, a bit more twitchy. When I'm bombing down a straight bit of track, it starts going down into the minute differences where it's not a big enough difference for me. It has to work with other things together for it to really make a difference.
Yeah, I found for me, I really noticed shorter offsets when, you know, when if you kind of, you know, we should always brake in a straight line with our bike, you know, perpendicular to the ground.
Doesn't happen.
It doesn't happen. Yeah. And if ever I was dragging my brake, the front brake, it felt the grip was more, maybe binary?
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean? I felt like as a mountain biker, I've conditioned myself to realize where the locking point and modulation is on the front wheel.
Yeah.
And it was kind of flying in the face of that. I think for short offset forks, whether they have their place or not is, well, they obviously do. But I think for me, I would have to commit to riding them.
Yeah.
And it would have to be the system I used, because I think it is quite a difference.
Yeah, for me, I've always been really sensitive to getting the weight balance of front to back wheel. And now there's just an extra thing to try and dial in to get that right. So yeah, I think for a lot of people, it can get confusing trying to find all these things to make their bike ride how they would like. Yeah. It's funny, when we had Martin's tandem, that's one thing when I really noticed the offset on that, with it flopping side to side and then changing it and making it feel more direct and feeling like you're not just going to go walk and sort of just flop over and lose your balance.
Because originally on Martin's bike, although he's currently running the setup that we are today, he actually just, they swapped around, reversed his lower.
So he did try that, yeah.
And that was the thing that opened up that big conversation.
Yeah, absolutely.
I mean, for me, I think there are actually some really important things to take away from this. The offset will be more effective when you've got a really slack head tube angle.
Yeah.
If, dog's in on it as well, if you've got a steeper one, then actually it moves it on that plane almost.
Okay.
So I think in terms of the effect and the amount of trail, I think we should do a second video where we do it with a downhill bike.
With a slacker head angle.
Yeah. I mean, the Stribe's, like, you know, such a fun bike to ride, but I don't think it's not, you know, some bikes have 63 degree head angles.
Yeah.
It's a few degrees off that.
Yeah.
And I think it'd be really interesting to try. But thank you for your time.
It's been good.
Thank you for, you know, riding the bikes, you poor sod. And to spend all day, you know, mountain biking.
Whoa.
The final say, does offset matter? Yes or no?
To me, not much.
Cool. Well, there we have it. It's a personal choice, part of a big equation. And like I said, there are no golden tickets in mountain biking. And, well, that's it. I want to make a joke about fork offset with these bad boys. I really am racking my brain, and I just can't get it done. So.
It's starting to bore me now, Henry, with your fork offset.
Fine. Well, let's end it there. Now, actually, the last time I came to the Forest of Dean was when I decided to do the laps, enough laps for a lifetime.
Yeah.
And I Everested this very hill. So I'm going to throw to that video.
You pedaled up that hill twice today. That must have been easy.
Honestly,
compared to 80.
I can't get my head around it. I was in a really weird mental space where 82 didn't seem like that much, but hey-ho.
It's a lot. And if you want to see GMBN throw their hats in the tech ring, two-pot versus four-pot Shimano video over there.
Always, don't forget to like and subscribe, and we'll see you next time.
See ya.
Ha ha.